Okay, I'm going to do a video on a quick, simple how to create a chart in Microsoft Access 2010. So I'll start with a query. I have a query here from my old weight database, and I created a query here where I have criteria to specify like a start date and an end date like this, right? So if I click on this, then it says enter the start date, right? It displays to the user whatever you have between the square brackets. So I could say for the start date 31/12/2011, which means December 31st. And for the end date, I will put 31/12/2012. Right, and it shows me these are the records. I think there's what about 10 records here, 9. Okay, so we know that the query works, right? You should always test the query first. Now we will create a chart based on that query. So the first thing you do is create a blank form. There's the form, and then you can save the form, and we'll save it under the name chart for weight. Okay, then I will go to design and I will add my close form button in the top left-hand corner because that's a rule and I always do that. And then we will go to controls and click on this thing with the three colors. That's the icon for the chart. And I'll drag out a big rectangle here to show the chart, and it asks you what query you want. I want this query weight parm that I just created, and I want two fields, the date and the weight. This is just a simple chart with two fields, and you have these different kinds of charts you can create. I want to do the 3D area chart, and then it says a sum of weight and it says the date by month, right? But I don't want the date by month. I want the date by day, right? So I click on there and I'll select a day here, right? And now it says the date by day. And then we'll go to next. What title would you want for your chart? This is what the user will see. So I'll type here chart for weight. And it says yes, display a legend. You should always say yes because you can always delete the legend later if you don't want it. This is just a mock-up chart that Microsoft creates. It's not the real data. It's just to show you what the chart will look like visually. Well, the first thing is I'm going to right-click on the button here, and then under position I'll say bring to front because I want the button to be on top of the chart. The close form button so the user can always see it. And now I'll minimize the navigation pane so that I can drag out the chart to a bigger area. You're always tight for space on these charts. Like it always seems like everything is smashed together, so you're always trying to do every little trick you can think of to make more space, right? So now I'm running the form. It says enter the start date. So again, I'll put 31/12/2011 for the start date, and I'll put 31/12/2012 for the end date. And then it shows me the chart, right? So this is your basic thing that's chart that's created by the wizard. And now you have to do all the kind of like fiddling around with it to make it look nicer. So let's go to design. First, I'll click on the chart. See the sizing handles. So what can we do to make it look nicer? First thing is to get rid of that legend because it's not really giving us any useful information. So I'll delete that. Then the date, see, we can go to this is the x-axis, right? If you remember from high school math, this is the y-axis, right? So I'm going to try to click on the x-axis, and it's always hard to make this chart thing understand what you want to do for some reason. So for example, I could change the alignment, right? I could make the text tilted like this, right? So you see there how the text is tilted. That makes it a little bit easier to see, maybe. And then I want to make the font smaller, right? So under font here, let's say I'll click on 8 for 8 point. I could also change, other things. I could change the font to Broadway. Oh, that's pretty ugly, right? Acroni, Algerian, Andalus. There's a lot of these weird fonts here, eh? I want Arial. Okay, you could also change the color, right? If you wanted it to be dark green, you could select the color here. Right, so there's the color and the font changed, right? Yeah, same with this, the blue shape there, that's called the plot area. So if I click on the plot area there, I can make it lime green, for example, right? Now the main thing is data labels. You almost always want data labels. So click on value here, and you see there's the data values, and it's got the stupid decimal points on it. So you have to go to number, then under number change the decimal points to 0. Right now it's more normal, right? And there's other things you can do, like with that the data values. It's very hard to click on what you want here. A lot of times you click on something and Microsoft Chart doesn't understand what it is that you're clicking on, and it'll give you the wrong thing, right? So there's a lot of trial and error involved in that, and that's the thing that makes it so frustrating, right? And that's the thing that makes it take so much time, right? So for example, if you wanted instead of Calibri, if you wanted Arial Black, right? And then if you wanted 11 point, you can make it like that. And if you wanted another color, right, you could click here and you could click on blue, right? And so now there the numbers are Arial Black, blue, 11 point font, right? So all of that kind of stuff you can do. And see, this is also a 3D graph, so I think it can even be modified to change the angle of view, right, like that. I don't know whether that's any better or not, but that is possible to do, right? But it's very finicky. It's very difficult to make a chart do what you want it to do, right? But you pretty well have to put up with that because there isn't really anything you can do about it. So that's the lesson for today anyways on how to make a chart, and thanks for watching.